Are you considering a career as a respiratory therapist? If so, you're probably wondering whether or not it's hard to get into respiratory therapy school. The short answer is yes, it can be quite difficult to get accepted. However, there are several things you can do to improve your chances, which is exactly what we're going to discuss in this video by breaking down the most common admission requirements. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. First and foremost, is it difficult to get accepted into respiratory therapy school? The field of respiratory care is expected to grow significantly over the next decade. This means that there will be many job openings for respiratory therapists in the coming years. However, this also means that competition for spots in respiratory therapy programs will be increased. Therefore, to increase your chances of being accepted, it's important to understand the admissions process and what schools are looking for in applicants. As previously mentioned, there are several requirements that you need to know in order to increase your chances of getting accepted. The first step in the admission process is to obtain a high school diploma or equivalent. If you haven't already completed high school, you'll need to do so before you can apply to a respiratory therapy program. This means finishing all high school requirements, completing a GED program, or taking the necessary courses at a local community college. The next step is to complete the required prerequisite courses. To become eligible to apply to respiratory therapy school, there are certain prerequisite courses that you'll need to complete. Some typical requirements include 1. ANP 1, 2. ANP 2, 3. College algebra, 4. English composition, and 5. General psychology. Keep in mind that most respiratory therapy programs will require you to complete these courses with a C or better. However, the exact requirements will vary from school to school. The next requirement is to maintain a competitive GPA. Your GPA is one of the most important factors in the respiratory therapy school admissions process. Most schools require a minimum GPA of 2.5 in order to be eligible to apply. However, the average GPA of accepted students is often much higher. Therefore, if your GPA is below the average, it's important to take steps to improve it before you apply. This may include taking additional courses or retaking classes you got a low grade in. In addition, schools will often look at your GPA over the last 2 years of college when making their decision. Therefore, it's important to maintain a strong GPA throughout your entire college career. The next step in the process is to submit an application to the colleges or universities that you're interested in. When completing your application, be sure to fill it out completely and accurately. In addition, be sure to include all required information and documents. And, in order to be eligible to apply to respiratory therapy school, you may need to submit proof of clinical experience or observation hours. This requirement is typically fulfilled by completing an internship or externship at a local hospital or medical facility. If you haven't previously worked in the medical field, it may be a good idea to spend time shadowing a respiratory therapist or volunteering in a hospital before you apply. This will give you a better understanding of the job and help you decide if it's the right career for you. The next requirement is to submit previous college transcripts. If you've taken any college courses in the past, you'll need to submit your transcripts when applying to RT school. This is important because schools need to see what types of grades you've been getting to determine if you're eligible for admission. If you've taken courses at multiple schools, be sure to request transcripts from each college that you've attended. And in addition to your transcripts, you may also need to submit your ACT or SAT scores when applying. The exact requirements will vary from school to school, but most require a minimum score of 18 on the ACT or 950 on the SAT. If you don't meet the minimum score requirements, you may still be able to apply if you have a strong GPA. However, your chances of being accepted will be lower. In addition to the items listed above, you may also need to submit letters of recommendation when applying to respiratory therapy school. These letters should be from people who can speak to your character and abilities, such as a teacher, coach, or employer. If you have any family members or friends who are respiratory therapists, they may also be able to write you a letter of recommendation. Once you've met all requirements and are prepared to submit your application, next you'll need to pay the required application fees. Most schools charge an application fee of around $50. However, the exact amount will vary from school to school. Be sure to check with each program to find out their specific requirements. After you've paid the necessary fees, your application will be reviewed by the admissions committee. If they determine that you're eligible for admission, you'll be contacted for an interview. The interview is your opportunity to show the committee why you're the best candidate for the program. Be sure to dress professionally and arrive prepared to answer any questions they may have. Once you've officially been accepted into an accredited respiratory therapy program, next, it's time to enroll and begin completing the required coursework. Congratulations on taking the first step towards a rewarding career as a respiratory therapist. And now you may be wondering, is respiratory therapy school worth it? For me personally, the answer is a resounding yes. Respiratory therapists play a vital role in the healthcare industry, and there is a high demand for qualified professionals. By enrolling in an accredited program, you'll gain the skills and knowledge you need to be successful in this rewarding career. However, respiratory therapy is not for everyone. The admission requirements are rigorous, and the coursework can be difficult. But if you're up for the challenge, I believe it's definitely worth it. Which brings us back to the initial question. Is it hard to get into respiratory therapy school? Yes, the application process can be competitive and challenging. However, by meeting all the requirements and following the steps outlined in this video, you'll increase your chances of being accepted into the program of your choice. If you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.